Hi guys, Matthew Woodward here, and today I'm going to teach you how to automate and manage guest posting. It's been a hot topic recently, and I wanted to share with you how I do it in the most efficient way possible. You're going to learn how to find thousands of guest post targets with my personal footprints, how to get all of the key stats on your target's database and filter them properly, how to automate the contact of all these sites in just a couple of clicks, how to sweeten your guest post proposition so they have no choice but to accept, and most importantly, how to track and manage all of it. The typical guest post process looks something like this. First of all, you have to find sites that accept guest posts. Then, you have to drop them an email with a request, speak with the site owner to negotiate a post, wait for them to publish it, track the results and make sure it doesn't get removed, and manually maintain a database of guest post partners. Now, if you only want to do a few guest posts, it doesn't take that long. But what about if you want to do 20 posts, or 100, or even thousands? Well, I have a solution for that by hacking LinkAssistant from SEO Power Suite. Let me show you what I mean. LinkAssistant is part of the SEO Power Suite package, and it's meant to be used to contact link exchange partners and then get your link added to their page of links. You'd probably know what I'm talking about, the old school method of you'd have a links page, and people would contact you to get their link placed on it, and then they would link back to you in return, and reciprocal linking and all that kind of thing. That's what it's meant to do. But with a few tweaks and a few hacks, you can actually use it to automate and manage guest posting. So I'm going to show you how to do that end to end. But before I do that, I wanted to show you a campaign that I've ran. So here you can see that there's a list of partner domains here that we can contact, the page rank, their email addresses, and also the status. So we can see I've got some guest post requests sent, guest post response, which means they've replied to my request, the guest post is live or not, and various things like that. And if you come over to the email section, you can see where here's the responses I've had to my requests. Here's one down here. I really appreciate your writing guest articles on my blog. You can post your own way as you like it. This one says, thanks for getting in contact. I'm always looking for quality guest posts. This one's asking me if I've got any articles currently. And yes, we only accept guest posts of high quality. So you can see there, I've got quite a lot of responses from the campaign that I sent out, and it's just a really easy way to manage the guest posting outreach and then the actual results of what's going on. So let me show you how to set this up, and I'm going to start a new project. So come up to File, New Project, enter domain.com into here and click next, and that will scrape some data we're not going to use, and click next. Contact name, enter your actual name, and for contact email address, you want to enter the email address you want to receive the guest post responses to. So that is going to be your actual email address. In this example, I'm going to use a temporary Hotmail account just for this tutorial, and then click on finish. Next, come up to Preferences, Proxy Settings, and onto Proxy Rotation. Import your list of private proxies here. Then, come up to the Email Client section, and we need to enter the server details for our email address. Now, what I typically do is my contact email would be my actual email address, matt@matthewwoodward.co.uk. I would then fill out the incoming mail server settings for that email address. But for the actual sending of the guest post request emails, I usually use a Hotmail or Yahoo account and use their outgoing mail servers. Now, you probably only need to do that if you're going to be sending out hundreds and hundreds of guest post requests. If you're only going to be sending a few a day or only a handful of requests, then you can use the outgoing mail settings for your primary contact email address. But if you're going to be sending hundreds, we're going to take advantage of Hotmail and Yahoo's SMTP servers, and then all of the requests will get sent through those, and any responses will get delivered to our primary email address. But for the sake of this video, I'm going to pretend that my temporary Hotmail address that I'm going to be using as the SMTP outgoing mail server is my actual main email address. So I'm just going to pause the video while I fill out these settings. One moment. Okay, they're set up now. It's always a good idea to test the connection once you've put in your details, so make sure you do that, then click OK. So let's now find some guest post targets. To do that, click on Search, Find Sites by Keyword Search, make sure Enable Expert Options is ticked, and click Next. Here we're going to write in URL, colon, and then write for us in quotation marks. And write for us is a common footprint that sites that accept guest posts use. I'm going to show you some more footprints and little tricks to find targets later on in the video, but just for now, in URL, colon, write for us in speech marks, and click Next. Here, untick all of the search engines and just select Google. And then you can decide to scan for an unlimited amount of potential guest post partners, or you can acquire a specified number. So just for this tutorial, I'm going to go out and find 10 potential partners and click Next. Interested partners filter, we skip. And here, leave all the options at default except for this one, and you need to tick Get Complete URLs. And here you can apply some various ranking factors and filters. You can actually add more filters and ranking factors, so it will go out and see how many times a domain's been mentioned on Twitter or any number of filtering options. There's loads of different ones here. You can pick what you like to see. Personally, all I want to see is the domain page rank, to see if we can get a decent backlink from a high PR domain, and also the Alexa rank to see if the guest post can generate any potential traffic. Ideally, we want to get a post on a high page rank domain with lots of traffic. So just select these two options here and click on Next. And that will go out and scrape for potential partners and pull in all of those metrics that we've just selected. So while it does that, I'm going to pause the video and I'll resume it once it's complete. Okay, now that's done, we can just click Select All, click on Next, and then click on Finish. And in here, straight away, we have got some details about our potential link partners. And if you come up to this little cog here and the Show All selected, click on Edit and add Domain PR and Alexa Rank, click on OK and then OK again. And there we can now sort by Domain PR and Alexa Rank. What you also want to do is sort by partner email and remove any that don't have an email address in this column. It tries to look them up automatically for you, but it's not always possible. So just remove these link partners here. The next thing that we need to do is set up the email template that we send to all of these guest post targets. So to do that, come to Preferences, Email Management, Edit Mail Templates, and then click Add to create a new template. We're going to call this Guest Post Request, and then you just need to enter a subject line for the email, which I usually just have as Guest Post Request. And I have a pre-prepared email template that I use. I will make this available for you to download underneath the video on my blog. You should use this as a template only to give you a rough idea of what you should be sending out. Please make sure that you tweak and edit it before you go and send it to everyone. And it just basically introduces myself, recognizes that they accept guest posts, and then I offer them an article that is 100% original, well written, SEO link building orientated, relevant to their audience, and exclusive to them. The added little bonus that I do down here is that I offer at least 25 Facebook likes and tweets to the guest post to help promote it. Now, you normally find blog owners falling all over themselves to take you up on this offer. But actually, all this is a cheap Fiverr gig that gives you a few tweets, a few likes. I think it also gives you some digs and some stumbles. But it only costs $5, and you can throw this little bonus line in on some of the more important targets. For example, you know, if you were trying to get links from PR6 domains, that might help sweeten the deal to convince them to accept your guest post. But all in all, that is just a Fiverr gig. It costs $5 and is just a nice way to entice people to accept your guest post request. So again, this template will be available underneath the video on my blog to download. Tweak it to your liking and then just paste it into this box and click on OK. And then we can click on OK again. So just to show you what the actual process looks like, I am just going to update the contact email address for one of these potential guest post targets so we can accept as both the requester and the person offering the guest post opportunity. So I'll just edit this link partner and change their email address to the Hotmail one we're using in this tutorial. What we all we need to do is click on the people that we want to email. You can do them one at a time, or you can select them all. I'm just going to do them one at a time, and then click on email here. Then in the mail template, you can select your guest post request template, and then just click on send. And it'll ask you if you want to put it in the outbox to send later or to send right now. But I'm just going to send that right now. So once that has sent, we will then check our inbox and the email tab and just click on receive here, and that will connect to the email box and download any emails. And we've not got anything just yet. Let's do another receive. There we go. So there's the guest post request. And this is as the person you've just sent it to would see it. And you can see I came across their page there with the their actual guest post URL. So that is what people would actually see when you send it out. Now, if you had thousands of partners, you can just highlight them all, click on email, select your guest post request, and then click send. And in this example, I'm not going to send these out, but it's that easy. One thing you should take note of, though, is if you come to Preferences, Email Management, and Email Client Settings, on the Mail Management tab here, you can enable delays between sending your emails. So if you're sending out 1,000 emails that are all roughly the same, you might want to have delays of, I don't know, 30 seconds to 3 minutes or something like that. But if you're just sending out a handful, you know, a few every day, you don't need to worry about this, really. I just wanted to touch on that delay option if you're going to be sending these out en masse. So after you have sent out your emails to contact your guest post partners, if you just right-click and go to Update Multiple Partners and Status, you can add in a few statuses. So we're going to add in guest post request sent, guest post response, and guest post live. So for all of the ones that we have just sent emails to, we're going to change the status to guest post request sent. And you can see that has changed there. And when you get a reply to a request, for example, I'll use this one here, you can just right click on it, update the status, and change that to guest post response. And if we come back here, you can see here that we know that this partner has responded to us and we are currently in negotiation of a guest post. After the guest post has gone live, again, you can come to the email tab, and let's say, for example, that this is our live guest post URL. We can right click here and go on edit link partner and go on the backlink to you and enter the URL of the live guest post here. and then click on OK. And then we can go on Update Multiple Partners, Status, and change that to Guest Post Live. And if we come back here, we can see that the status has changed to Guest Post Live and the URL of the guest post. So that, when you're doing thousands of guest post requests, or even just 50 or a handful, you can see how keeping track of everything here and updating the little statuses and managing it from this email inbox here makes it really easy to manage all of your guest posting campaigns. So what I wanted to take you through next was how to import thousands of targets and really take this to the next level. The built-in scraper of Link Assistant is pretty limited, but I'm going to show you how to leverage Scrapebox and import a huge target list into here and then filter them all out. So let's head over to Scrapebox. So if you enter a list of niche-related keywords, in my case I'm going to use SEO, link building, social media, and then I have my own list of guest post footprints, and you can merge those against your list. Now, these guest post footprints are available to download underneath this video on my blog, so come and grab those and then use them to merge with your keyword list, and then just click on Start Harvesting. And I'm going to pause the video while that completes. And once that's done, you want to export your URL list and copy it to clipboard and jump back over to Link Assistant. Now, I'm only using 106 targets here, but you can quite happily use thousands. Just make sure you've got them onto your clipboard, and I'll see you back in Link Assistant. Next, we need to import those target URLs. So if we come to File, Import, plain text, and we can just paste them in here and click on Next. Make sure Enable Expert Options is ticked. Make sure we tick Get Complete URLs, leave these other settings at default. Again, you can set up ranking factors and filters. I'm just going to check the domain Google page rank and the Alexa rank. If you want to add more factors in, you can do down here. Click on Next, and that will go out and import the URL list and get all of that data for us. So I'm just going to pause a video while it does that. Okay, that's finished. So select all, click on Next, and click Finish. And there we go. You can see we've now got a new list of targets imported. We can remove any that don't have the partner email. And yeah, I think that is there. And now you can either choose to select them all and drop an email out to all of them. I'm not going to do that in this example. Or you can be more specific and say, well, I want to post on a site that's got a decent Alexa rank and therefore traffic and actual visitors and subscribers, and just select the ones with the best Alexa rating. You can pretty much do what you want from this point on. Some people will be happy just sending out a few guest post requests at a time. Other people will want to send out thousands of them. Just make sure that if you're going to be sending out a lot of requests in your settings here, to add delays and to make sure you're using a Yahoo or Hotmail outgoing mail server. It's likely at some point this account will be banned and terminated, but if that does happen, any responses to sent emails will get sent back to this incoming mail setup and the contact email address here. So all of that is worth noting. And that brings me to the end of the tutorial. You now know how easy it is to automate and manage all of your guest posting with a few tweaks and hacks of Link Assistant. There is a free trial available to download, so you can familiarize yourself with the software, and the link is on your screen now. It is also worth noting that Link Assistant is part of the SEO PowerSuite package of tools, which also includes Website Auditor for doing on-site SEO audits, SEO Spyglass to download and analyze your backlinks, as well as Rank Tracker to track all of your rankings. I use SEO PowerSuite on a daily basis and consider it an essential tool for any serious SEO. check out the free trials and see what you think.